Now, without a doubt, one of the biggest misconceptions in golf is what you should be thinking about when making a swing. Should you be focusing on the golf ball? Should you be focusing on the target? If you're confused with this, stay tuned. This video is really gonna help. Let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel, guys. Kerrod Gray here in the studio at Joondalup Resort. Before we get stuck in, please go down below, click subscribe, click that little bell so you get notified of all the great content coming your way. All right, in today's lesson, we're gonna be talking about hitting the golf ball versus swinging at your target in its most simplistic fashion. I'm gonna show you the two types of swings that I generally see the recreational golfer make, one being a swing or a motion at the golf ball versus at the target. We're gonna be talking about some of the characteristics that I see between the two, and especially the one that I would recommend that you start to implement into your game, specifically what you should be thinking about when you're out on the golf course. So let's start off, first of all, at hitting at the golf ball, swinging at the golf ball when the ball's on the ground. Well, if I set up to this golf ball, and I'm a player who swings to the top, now from here, if I'm under the impression that my focus, and this is very common that I hear with a lot of recreational golfers, is that they need to hit the golf ball. Well, generally what we're gonna see from the top of the swing is an aggressive move of the upper body. The arms will tend to move out and towards the golf ball. The shaft will tend to get a little bit steep. The golf club will tend to descend too much down into the ground, and that's where you're gonna get some fat shots. Or if the golf club gets in too steep of a fashion, your body compensates, starts to jump up, you can top it, shank it, thin it, everything in between. So really ball contact issues is a lot to do with what you are focusing on specifically when you're playing. Now, very commonly, what players tend to do when they're out on the golf course is they start to get a little bit too internally focused about what they're doing when they're playing, how they're swinging the golf club. Now, really what you need to be focused on is what you want to achieve, not how you're performing the motion. So for example, a simple analogy, if I was throwing a golf ball down in this direction, say there was a pole that I wanted to hit. If I was in a performance setting, so for example, if I was going to win a prize, if I hit this pole, I would not be focused on the angle of my wrist. I would not really be focused on the release point of the golf ball coming out of my hand. What I would be focused on is the target. Now, when I'm focused on the target, that is an external cue. That is going to encourage my body to work in such a fashion in which my body movements will then accommodate that outcome that I've established in my mind. So therefore, quite different from me being too internally focused about the process. When we're focused on the process, we tend to get a little bit too mechanical. Now, this is okay and this is reasonable if you're working on the mechanics of your golf swing. But what we're talking about here is when you're out on the golf course, what you need to be focusing on to get out of your own way. Now, what I generally tend to see is players who are focused too much on hitting the golf ball, they're making this their primary target. They're making the ball on the ground their number one objective. Now, when I do that, you can see certain movement patterns seem to come into play because they are the instructions that I'm giving my brain that I need to hit something down on the ground. Now in reality, golf is played out there. We need to send our ball to a target in the distance. Our target is not actually the ball on the ground. We need to be swinging towards the target and the ball's simply going to get in the way. Now when we do that, let's look at some of the characteristics of a swing in which we're more target orientated. So I'm gonna set up to this golf ball. And if I was a player who swung to the top, and I was going to feel like I'm projecting some force down towards the target rather than at the ball, we're going to see some different mechanics start to take place. We might see a shift towards the target with the lower body. We might see a shallowing of the shaft. We might see these arms get into a position where we're throwing the energy out towards the target rather than down at the ball. And you can see how that definitely changes the movement of the body, number one, and also the pitch and plane of the shaft and how it's gonna deliver into the golf ball. Now, this is just a simple mentality that you can take out to try and eradicate any process-dominated thoughts if you're getting a little bit too technical and tight when you're playing, Or if you are simply just focusing too much on the golf ball, you can start to think a lot more about the target and what you want to achieve. Now, when you do this, what's going to happen is it's going to free you up. And you're going to be able to get some fluidity to the motion. We're going to be swinging out in the direction of something rather than down at the golf ball. Once again, the golf ball is not our target. We are swinging out towards a target. The golf ball is simply going to get in the way. Now, there's a really old school drill out there. Now, I wouldn't recommend doing it at the range, but if you've got a paddock or something, this is a great exercise to do. Just make sure you've got enough room. Grab an old golf club. And what I want you to do is set up into this position. And I want you to actually throw the golf club. And when you throw the golf club, I want you to throw it out in the direction of the target. Now, generally, what we're going to see with most players is they'll either throw it way too early down into the ground, or they'll actually hold on to it and it will fling around the corner. So getting that feeling of throwing the momentum out towards the target is just going to give you the sensation of swinging and projecting that momentum in a directed manner towards our actual target, which is the pin or the fairway or a specific point throughout the golf course that we're aiming for, not down at the golf ball. So if you're a player who has some characteristics in your golf swing that have not changed for a long time, no matter how many drills, no matter how many exercises that you've been doing to try and get out of this over the top motion, it simply could require a shift in mentality. And that mentality could be as simple as thinking about where you want to swing it rather than how you are going to hit it. So I hope you've enjoyed today's video. Once again, clearing up the difference between if you should be swinging and hitting down at the golf ball or out towards a target. In a very simplistic fashion, let's divert our focus more towards the target. Let's get us swinging that golf club, directing that force, directing that motion out to where we want to send the golf ball, not down at the ground. If you're struggling with this, I'm sure this little drill, this little mentality is going to help a lot to improve your ball striking in the year ahead. As always, if you haven't already, please go down below, click subscribe, ask me any questions in the comments. I'll be happy to help. But until next time, I'm Kerrod Gray. Thanks for watching.